Hi students, today's experiment is common emitter amplifier. So in the common emitter amplifier, aim of this experiment is to obtain the frequency response of common emitter BJT amplifier and to measure the voltage gain and bandwidth of the C amplifier. This is the circuit diagram for common emitter amplifier. So using kit, so I am using kit. So this is the kit of common emitter amplifier, small signal CE amplifier. Okay, here your required components are transistor, resistors, capacitors. Okay, so this is BC107 capacitor transistor and capacitor collector resistor will be 6.8 kilo ohms and R emitter resistor will be 330 in series, so total 660 ohms and biasing resistors are R1 is 47 kilo ohms and R2 is 4.7 kilo ohms. Input resistance RX is 1 kilo ohm resistor and output load is 1 kilo ohm resistor we are using. Here coupling capacitors are input side C 10 microfarad and output side is 10 microfarad and bypass emitter capacitor is C is 100 microfarad. So this is internally connected already it is. So here white line will be there. White line indicates internal connection will be there. So without white line means there is no connection in between here this node to this node. So here there is no line. So this node to this node it is open circuit, open it is. So wherever line will be there is internally connected. Okay. Next, in that amplifier we have to go. First we have to do measurement of DC conditions. For DC conditions we require only self bias circuit. So self bias circuits only this component. This is only transistor RC, R1, R2 and RE. So remaining are open. So for DC conditions we require only R1. R2, RC, RE and transistor and we have to supply at VCC. Okay, in that we have to calculate VCE, IC, IE, VBE and VB. Okay, why? Because the amplifier is biased in the active region and whether the Q point is suitably located or not. That's why we are using DC conditions here. First we have to connect the circuit as self-bias circuit. This is self-bias circuit, same as I am connecting here, self-bias circuit. Okay, so this is supply VCC 12 volts I am applying here and here there is no line means we have to connect externally, wiring we have to connect externally here. So R2 to ground and RE to ground. So I am connected here only self-bias circuit. Self-bias circuit means 12 volt supply RC, R1, transistor, RE and R2. Only this part is connected here. Okay. So there is no line means I am connected externally with wiring, connecting wire. Okay. Next we have to calculate DC values. So here VB base to ground. So I am grounded here and connecting base here and multimeter. So here multimeter will be there. So voltage will be 1st switch on the DC supply. So here this is VB voltage. VB is base to ground. Base to ground. I am connected. Multimeter positive is connected to base and negative is connected to ground. So base to ground is VB. VB is 1.07 volts. So this is practical value. Okay. Practical value is VB is 1.07 volts. By theoretically we have to calculate VB equal to VCC into R2 by R1 plus R2. This is formula for VB, calculation for theoretical. VB equal to VCC into R2 by R1 plus R2. So VB equal to VCC is 12 volts, I have applied connected here, VCC supply voltage is 12 volts, so R2 is 4.7k, R1 is 47k plus R2 is 4.7k, so 4.7 by adding this one, so 51.7k, So we get VB equal to 56.4 by 51.7 K. K will cancel, so it will cancel. So we will get VB is 1.09 volts. VB is 1.09 is, this is theoretical value. Practically we are getting 1.07 volts. Practical value VB is 1.07 volts, approximately equal. This is practical and is theoretical. Okay, VBE already you know, theoretical is VBE for any transistor, that is 0.7 volts. Okay, now we have, you can check here VBE, base to emitter voltage. This is 0.650, that is base to emitter voltage. I am connecting here base to emitter terminal, that is 0.649. So I am getting practical, theoretical is 0.7 volts. This is theoretical is 0.7 volts. And practical is 0.649 volts, practically VBE. So you know VBE equal to VB minus VE. So VE equal to what happened? VE equal to VB minus VBE. So VE equal to 1.09 minus 0.7. That is VE equal to 0.39 volts. That is, this is theoretical value. So practically we can measure in kit. So VE, emitter terminal to ground. So emitter terminal to ground. So emitter to ground is 0.47 volts. So 0.47, this is 0.39, approximately 0.4. So 0.47 volts. This is practical, approximately equal. So IC is VRC by RC. RC voltage. RC, how to measure the IC? Here there is no connection here, so we can calculate voltage across RC by RC resistor. So voltage across RC, now I am calculating voltage across RC. So connect at RC terminal, so you will get four point five volts, that is voltage across RC, 4.5 by 6.8 kilo-ohms. So you will get approximately 0.69 milliamps, approximately 0.69 milliamps. So you can calculate here, measure IE value now. IE is theoretically, practically you can calculate here. So you can measure IE is approximately here. So keep it in multimeter in milliamps mode. And we can say here open circuit will be there. So we can measure IE here. Emitter in terminal to ground. Emitter to ender. That is 0.7 milliamps. That is 0.7 milliamps is IE. So IE is 0.7 milliamps means you know IE equal to approximately IC. Okay. So IC is about 0.669 is theoretically, and IE is 0.7 milliamps practically. Okay, next we have to calculate VCE. VCE. So VCE is collector to emitter terminal. Collector to emitter terminal. VCE. So I am connecting collector terminal is resistor in terminal and emitter is here. So it is, so collector to emitter, emitter to emitter is 6.89 volts, that is VCE. So VCE is, you got 6.39 volts, okay, 6.89 volts, 6.89 volts, this is VCE. So you can calculate VC minus VE. So you know VC is from collector to emitter terminal. So this is 7.3 volts. VC, collector to ground, that is VC voltage. VC is collector to ground is how much you got? 7.3 volts. 7.3 volts. So you can VCE equal to you know VC minus VE. Okay. So VE, how much we got here? Emitted to ground, that is 0.46 volts. 0.46 VE is 0.46 volts. So VC is 7.3. 7.3 minus 0.46, you will get approximately 6.89 volts. That is VCE. VCE and IC is 0.7 milliamps, VCE is 6.89 volts. You can calculate theoretical and practical. Okay. Next, we go to signal handling capacity. Measurement of signal handling capacity. In the measurement of signal handling capacity, you have to short the 1 kilo ohm resistor, that is input side, by using connecting wire. Here I am connecting, using connecting wires, I am shorting this one, 1 kilo ohm resistor, and applying input signal from function generator. So I am connecting here positive, negative, negative of the probe. Okay. And here output side, here I am using channel 1 is using for output purpose and channel 2 is using for input purpose. So input channel 2 probe is connected same at function generator probes, positive positive, negative negative. Okay, I am using here. For why we are using signal handling means, in the amplifiers we have to connect, input voltage is constant. So up to what input voltage we have to use, so we can measure here. So here I am increasing the input voltage amplitude. So from input side increasing this, output voltage also same sine wave form. So this is input voltage, this is output voltage. Okay, that is amplified voltage. This is amplified voltage, this is input voltage. So increasing this one, output voltage also increases. Up to certain voltage it is increasing, after that it is distorting. Wherever it is distorting voltage, that voltage will be maximum signal handling voltage. Here now it is distorting. Here it starting distorting the output voltage. So this voltage respected input voltage is here VSM voltage. Okay. Now check it. Now again I am increasing the input voltage slowly. So increasing this one, so output voltage also increases, that is amplified voltage. And up to certain voltage it is increasing, after that output voltage will be distorting. Here now it is distorting, output voltage is distorting here. So this corresponding input voltage is VSM, that is maximum signal handling voltage. Input voltage is how much voltage? One point eight into 0.5 is 0.9 volts. So this 0.9 voltage is VSM voltage. This is the VSM voltage of this one, this signal handling capacity. So VSM voltage is, VSM is 0.9 volts. 1.8 into 0.5. So that is 0.9 volts. So next we have to go for frequency response of CE amplifier. Frequency response of CE amplifier, we have to fix the input voltage. Fixing the input voltage, that input voltage is less than the VSM voltage. So we have to fix the input voltage, that is constant voltage in the frequency response, that input voltage is constant less than the VSM voltage. VSM is less than the input voltage, is less than the VSM voltage. So I am applying here now input voltages by using this amplitude. Fixing the input voltage, that is 0.5 voltage. I am applying input voltage is 0.5 volts. 0.5 volts, I mean fixing the input voltage, that is first frequency response, I am input voltage is 0.5 volts. This is input voltage. Okay, 0.5 voltage is fixing, and you have to increase the frequencies. In the frequency response, you have to increase the frequencies from 100 Hz to maximum 3 MHz, that is function generator is maximum 3 MHz only. You have to increase 100 Hz to maximum 100 frequencies, and you have to measure the output voltages. Okay, so this is the table of frequency response of CE amplifier. So frequency in Hz, output voltage, gain equal to output by B input, gain in dB equal to 20 log of gain. Okay, from this you have to draw the graph, gain in dB versus frequency. So now I am input voltage is here 0.5 volts. 0.5 volts, I am fixing the 0.5 volts, that is fixing the input voltage is constant. And here frequency response, increase the frequencies from 100 Hz to 3 MHz. In the signal handling, we are fixing the frequency is constant, input is variable. In the frequency response, input is constant, frequency is variable. Okay. Next, we have to increasing from low frequencies. Now, yes, at 5 Hz, what happened? In the 5 Hz, at low frequencies means it is oscillating, the output voltage will be oscillate. It is a 5 Hz frequency, it is 5 Hz. So, output voltage will be from here to here, that is 1.6 into 2 volts. Output voltage is 1.6 into 2. Okay, this is next frequency is 30 Hz. At 30 Hz, output voltage is from here to here, that is exact 2 volts, 2 into 2. So 2 into 2 volts, 4 volts. Next, we have to increase frequency 100 Hz. Like 100 Hz frequency, output voltage is 2.2. So 2.2 into 2. 2.2 into 2 volts. Next, applying 1 kilohertz frequency. At 1 kilohertz frequency also, we are getting 2.2. 2.2 into 2. 2.2 into 2 volts. Next, 3 kilohertz frequency. So it is voltage will be constant, we are getting at 3 kHz also. 3 kHz you can see we are getting same 2.2 into 2 volts. So it is constant up to 30 kHz. 30 kHz also here we are getting 30 kHz frequency, we are getting also same output voltage is 2.2 into 2. 2.2 into 2 volts. Next, if to increase the frequencies, next to 60 kHz. At 60 kHz also, we are getting 2.2 volts. 60 kHz, 2.2 into 2 volts. Okay, next increase the frequencies up to. So we are decreasing now. At high frequencies, output voltage is decreasing. Now it is decreasing at 100 kHz. At 100 kHz or 110 kHz. Frequency. I am getting it is slightly decreases. It is I am getting 2 into 2 volts. 2 into 2 volts. Next, again, if you are increasing the frequencies, output voltage is decreases. Now it is at 170 kHz. 170 kHz frequency, we are getting 1.8 into 2 volts. Okay, next increasing the frequencies. At 280 kHz frequency, 280 kHz frequency, I am getting 1.6. Now it is decreases 1.2 into 2 volts. Okay, at change the frequencies. Okay, at 580 kilohertz, 580 kilohertz, I am getting S2 1 into 2 volts, 1 into 2 volts. So total box is 1 into 2 volts. If you are increasing the frequencies, this decreases. At 800 kilohertz, 800 kilohertz, we are getting 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.7 it is. 0.7 into 2. At 800 kilohertz, 0.7 into 2. Next, 1.2 megahertz. 1.3 megahertz. 1.3 megahertz frequency. Output voltage is 0.4 into 2 volts. Okay. Next, if we are increasing the at high frequencies, at 2 megahertz frequency. At 2 megahertz frequency, output voltage is 0.3 into 2 volts. If you are increasing this one high, 2.6 kilohertz, you are getting 2.6 megahertz. You can see 0.2. This 0.2 into 2 volts. Like that, you can give. Next, if you are increasing high frequencies, it is goes to high. So at 3 megahertz frequency, at 3 megahertz frequency, the output voltage is 0.1 into 2 volts. 0.1 into 2 volts. Next, we have to calculate here gain. Gain equal to V output by V input for all values. Okay. So, from these values, I have calculated gain. Gain equal to V output by V input. So, 1.6 into 2 is 3.2, 3.25 is, we are getting 6.4 volts. Like that, you have calculated all the values of gain. So gain equal to V output by V input. And gain in dB. Gain in dB equal to 20 log of gain. So 20 log of 6.4 is 16.12. 20 log of 8 is 18.06. 20 log of 8.8 is 18.88. This voltage is constant up to 60 kHz. After that, it is decreases. So starting, it will be increases 16.2, 18.06, 18.88. After that, it is constant up to 100 Hz to 60 kHz, it is constant. After that, it is decreases. Okay, 18.06, 17.14, 13.16, like that, it is decreases. So now, we have to draw the graph. Graph in between gain in dB versus frequency. Gain in dB versus frequency. This is the graph of gain in dB versus frequency. Frequency in x-axis, gain in y-axis. So this is the graph. 100 Hz, 1K, 10K, 100K, 100K, 1 MHz. Okay. Here, in y axis, I have taken 2, 1 division equal to 2 units. So, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, like that. So, from this values, I have taken the values and I have drawn this one. From this, we have to calculate gain, my bandwidth. Okay. Bandwidth is FH minus FL. This is the constant voltage, constant gain, 18.88. So we have to calculate the bandwidth. We have to take it minus 3 dB from this voltage. So 15.88, we have to draw the straight line here, from here to here, and draw a straight line on frequencies, okay, in x-axis. So I have drawn values at low frequencies. FL is 3 Hz and FH is 260 kilohertz. So bandwidth will be FH minus FL. So 260 kilohertz minus 3 hertz. So this is bandwidth of common emitter amplifier. Okay, using graph. Okay, thank you.